Good afternoon, anyone? Oh, a lot of people. I thought you were talking about Microsoft and open source. I will have like five people around, but thank you for coming. It's a kind of my own experience or experiences within Microsoft doing open source since now 7-8 years. I will try to focus mainly on the pitfalls or what's going on, how I did it, or how patient I have had to be, which is, I'm totally not patient, so it was quite hard. So I'm not focusing on Microsoft marketing or product and so on. So, and also try to see, to understand what you, how you see Microsoft now, because a lot of things have changed the last couple of, since many years. The only difference since the last 2-3 years, Microsoft is talking much more about what they do on an open source way. So just to see what's going on. This is where you can contact me if you have any question or if you need something within the project we do at Microsoft, or if you use something on Azure, SQL Server, or whatever you need, even Windows Phone and so on, get in touch. Or you can also get in touch with Adam over there. He's the guy responsible for open source in Australia, or the area at large. Very nice guys. He doesn't bite, so don't be afraid. So, I have to say that because I'm talking on my own. It's not something, I don't have to put that, but I put it just to know it's not the Microsoft position or whatever. Could be some of them not, so I will try to be quite objective. Some statistics. So, question, who knows Azure? So, Adam, you have a lot to do here. Azure, sorry. I don't know what you said here. Azure? Yeah. 3, 4. You have some job to do. couple of questions. What do you think about Microsoft now, today? Sorry, you were in front of me. Two words. I mean, good, bad.
Past their prime.
Sorry?
Past their prime.
That's a pity? I have to agree on that for a couple of things.
Can I have a Microsoft Surface Pro 3, please?
What do you want?
A Microsoft Surface Pro 3, please.
I didn't get it.
Microsoft Surface.
He wants a Surface Pro.
I tried to get one since it's...
They run Linux really well.
Yeah, it does. And that's the best laptop you can have. But I'm fighting now for the band, so... Hey, I try to be healthy. So, who knows that... who heard about Microsoft doing open source at large? Or who did not?
Did not.
Did not. And the other, because who did? And a couple without opinion, okay. And okay, so I will do a reverse talk. So I will talk about where we are now, and I will explain how we went there. So if we take Azure, it's a cloud, it's like Amazon, Amazon Web Services. You know what Amazon Web Services is, right?
Yes.
Okay. So 20% of all instances are running on Linux now. Be Red Hat, whatever you want, and so on. So you have quite a lot of instances. And it's growing daily, weekly, be here or in US or Europe, a lot in Asia as well. So it's quite impressive, and it's been a long, long road to get here. You can use whatever you want. I didn't list all languages, but this is the languages we use. For those having been in my talk yesterday, you know that I do a lot of PHP or around PHP, but we also do everything around the web, everything to do with web. So web architecture like MongoDB, Couchbase, MySQL, or more MariaDB now, and so on. And we have contributed to all the language. I don't care much about Java, but Node.js, PHP, Ruby, Python. That's what we do in our team. Being the languages themselves, or the libraries, or the application frameworks, and so on, written in one of these languages. And everything we do, I will talk about that later, is open. We work directly with the community. We don't have private discussion and so on. We were like the top Linux kernel contributor in 2012 for the kernel. I mean, like, when we discuss that, like, think about 10 years ago, you say, who are the top contributors for the Linux kernel? And you say, Microsoft is part of it. Yeah. I have some doubt, but we were. It changed a bit because what we did back then, it's part of, I work for the, by the way, for the Open Source Tech Center. We have two entities doing mainly all the open source stuff. It's Open Source Tech Center, which is internally in Microsoft, and we have a subsidiary called OpenTech, which does all the Node.js stuff and so on. And OSTC do, the OSTC teams do all the kernel developments and Linux, jlibc, and so on. Quite some good guys. It's only funny when I walk around there and bringing some colleagues from other teams, they don't see a single Windows around. We are all using Linux and so on in our offices. And we are still a top contributor in PHP, like two of my team. I don't count myself inside because I do that since the very beginning, but two of the top five are in my team, either from the code contribution or QA and so on. It's only for the code contribution, but we do also a lot of QA. this is basically only a few projects we do, or we contribute to. That's the most known one. And I suppose this is. This is what I like coming in right now, and this one too. It was a long battle, a long road to do it. And this is a classic one. Everyone knows WordPress, Joomla, or maybe Symfony. I don't know if it's well known in Australia. It's a frame. You know Drupal? Okay, Drupal 8, the next version, use Symfony as a base. So Symfony is a framework component base. And Drupal use now Symfony to do that. So it's very easy to integrate. It's a very nice framework. And take a look if you don't know it. If you have questions, I can help you a lot about that. And maybe next year and so on, I will try to bring the people talking about Symfony, because I think there is not only Drupal, but many other projects use it. So could be one of the best next thing in the PHP world for that. And this is, for me, the best thing since years, even better than PHP. You know Docker? I mean, yeah, we met already, I think. I was like, oh, this guy should be at the conference. But who does not know Docker? Okay, you did a good job, Adam, see? And indeed, we also support for the mobile devices. Outside Windows Phone, we do a lot of open source stuff, like Cordiva. You know Cordiva? It's a kind of framework to do portable application for mobile devices. It's an Apache project, so you can do, with one single project, you can do an app for Android, iOS, or Windows Phone. Works pretty well. And Hadoop, Elasticsearch, Redis, Memcached, and so on and so on. There are dozens of projects. I cannot follow them, all of them anymore. But this is between Docker, Chef, and Puppet. This is basically filling the gaps that we had before. And we are working now to add Windows support to Docker. So then you can use the same tools no matter what you use. And this is also what is done not directly by our teams, but using partner, except for FreeBSD. This is now also in our team. But this is also like DocumentDB, MongoDB, we discussed that before. Where are you? Over there. And we made bridges between SQL Server, MongoDB, optimizing MongoDB for Windows, or on the Azure platform, and so on. And indeed, every contribution we did, like in the kernel, we improved a lot the virtualization part. It benefits not only for us, it was a benefit for everyone, because everyone used virtualization, including Amazon or Google used something else, but it's pretty much a benefit for everyone. Do you have questions until now, or did I miss a project? Okay. And you have one thing, that was the thing I wanted to have, and since many years. If I get one single no to this question, I will wonder to who I'm talking to. Who knows, or who does not know apt-get?
I don't know.
Okay, but you are not in IT, are you? Okay. you know what a package is when you have a okay, this is something to install it. So, and we got one for Windows as well now. So it's called OneGet. It's Garrett Serac doing that. By the way, everything I talk about now, you can find it on GitHub. Almost all our projects are on GitHub, so you can contribute or whatever, including this one. It was in the beginning on Codeplex, which is a kind of GitHub done by Microsoft. But a lot of people say, oh, but it's Boeing, and we don't want to have many, so just do it on GitHub, and we moved everything on GitHub. And this is a very, very cool thing. So you can just do like one get install, blah, 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 or update, and so on. You can have many channels. It's a bit easier than apt-get because you can do it directly on the command line. You don't have to edit a source file and so on. But very cool thing. It will be by default installed with Windows 10. And but you can still fetch it, install it now from Windows 7 and up. So very, very handy thing. And one of the things it uses, it's called NuGet. It's also backend for OneGet to install it. It's like when you have on Debian, you have the, I don't use it.
Exactly.
Yeah, you can use one or the other. And NuGet we have a website called Chocolatry. Or you can publish whatever you do on Chocolatry, and people will be able to install it in one command line. So it's chocolatry.org. And you have like, I don't remember, but the numbers are here. Couple of thousand package and do updates. You have PHP on there and so on. So this is one of the, I think, the best thing Windows 10 will have by default, besides the start menu. Yeah, we are working on that too. Because the OneGet, it will not do the configuration for you. The setting, and you know, the 3 days, the 1 month you will spend to configure SharePoint, you will still do it, don't worry. But I was joking, you need to do less than that. Maybe 4 weeks. So, I'm sorry, I don't use it, I try it on. So I only use the web services for it. So because you have web services for SharePoint, I use it with Drupal and so on, very cool thing. Because I didn't find any good document management system, open source or web-based. There is no good one. You can say there are some, but you have no good one. What SharePoint does, it's quite advanced. Anyway. Closing the ad. And so this is a Chocolatry package. So if you have something, a product you do open source or not, you can upload it there for your Windows user and so on. So now, how does all these things happen? It was a freaking long road with a lot of thunder, because I do that since 8 years. I did that before. So the story was, I do open source it since quite a long time. I won't say how long, because then you will know how old I am. And at some point, around 8 years ago, it was Hank Jensen. he was responsible for the kernel team, the kernel developer team. Nothing to do with PHP, and he came to me at a conference and he said, well, what do you think about doing what you do now, but for us? Like improving PHP on Windows, the web platform stack on Windows, because we are way behind. My answer was, yeah, you're not behind, you don't exist. So, and we found an agreement like, okay, I will not work for Microsoft, but I will stay independent. So I do pretty much what I want as long as we do the right thing for the customers and for Microsoft. And it works pretty well since 8 years. And that's how my team works. So we don't have the classic Microsoft way. We have some goals for a year, but it's not the corporate way. When you still have reviews and so on, but we adapt. We are pretty agile, so we adapt depending on what's going on now or what will be next year and so on. So we try to. We are one of the only, for example, project with PHP with the same team, the same developers working on the same project since 8 years. So it allows us to have a better relationships with the communities. I will come to that later, which is very, very helpful, especially for PHP. Because in general, I think you know that almost as good as I do. You have many politics in big corporation, but you have just as much politics in open source projects. So mixing both together can be quite painful. So that was when I came to Microsoft. So it was quite a bad start. So I was talking at a conference, and the first question was, why do you say that? And I say, I did not. So it was only my CEO. I mean, I don't even know him. So, and so it was pretty bad. I mean, and you will still, I mean, I'm pretty sure within the next months you will hear something like that, like, oh, open source is not good for business and so on from a Microsoft guy. just like you hear something for a government representative, because we have, I don't know, now 100,000 people working for Microsoft, so pretty hard to control everyone, especially the legal part. They are sometimes very abstract. But now the hell has frozen. That means many, many, many product teams have changed. So that means for the story, the first talk I gave about what I do at Microsoft was internally at Microsoft. You know TechEd? It's a kind of big event for all Microsoft customers or new customers and so on. And I gave an internal talk to all the DPE, it's a developer evangelist, and everyone in the room, it was like, I don't remember, 300 people. And I began my talk like, what is open source? And everyone was smiling at me like, oh, what you are talking about? And making jokes and, we don't need open source and it's slow or it's unsafe and all possible classic questions. And now the same guys, we work together now and they call me or like Adam and so on, we work together closely or they work with the communities and so on and so on. And it began from the bottom and it was slowly growing until one of these guys working with us or working with open source since many years became the CEO. And this is our new CEO. I don't remember his name. Satya, sorry. You will. I'm bad with names, so don't be mad if I don't remember your names either. So, and he became there and changed totally the whole thing. Because at the end of the day, it doesn't matter. And no matter if you do that for Microsoft or if you're a big customer like a bank or and so on, it's the same process. You have to explain him why it's good, what matters. I mean, what is your job? Your core business or the software? The software is not your job. It doesn't matter what you use as long as you do your business. So for us, with all the cloud services and so on, whether someone uses Linux, Windows, PHP, .NET, whatever, doesn't matter. Just use whatever you want. And if you can or if you like to, use it on Azure or Azure. Tell me, Azure or Azure here? Anyway, in France, it's a French name. In France, we say Azure, and in English, we say Azure, so I don't even say. Yeah. I know, but it's how you say it, because in French, you say Azure, but in France, they call it Azure for the cloud services, but when you're in English countries, it's the other way around. Maybe it's an exotic part or. So, and as I said before, you have a lot of politics involved to achieve the goal, because you have to think, like, who works with big companies here, like customers? Yeah. You know how it is, like you talk to one GM and you talk to another one and they have like opposite views? It's like that inside Microsoft, except that you have thousands of them. So it was pretty hard, it's still pretty hard to get teams working together. It's getting better, but you have to think like 100,000 people think the same way. So it takes time. So, and to convince everyone or to get, for example, one of the, for UKs, I needed like 3 years to convince the SQL Server team to create a PHP driver on an open, to create a PHP driver first for Windows. Because when I released 7 minutes, or I'll speed up. When I released, for example, PHP 5.3, it was the first, I rewrote everything to use Windows API. And the only thing I was not able to do was the SQL Server driver. So that means it was a kind of ironic that the first two Windows PHP version did not have SQL Server support. So they did not get it. They said, oh, there is no customers and so on. And I needed 3 years like asking big customers, banks and so on to call them or to make a report to say we need SQL Server internally, because we were not talking to these guys saying, like big companies say, oh, we don't talk to Microsoft about what we do on open source because Microsoft does not do open source. So, but now it's changing also a lot. I mean, also even for you guys, if you work with big companies and you say, hey, you have Windows, but it works with open source, and they tell you, oh, no, they don't, you can say, hey, we do, and we know the right guys, and we can support you, and so on and so on. And it's a lot about processes on both sides. That means every single open source project has processes. Even if there is no process, it's a kind of process. So, and one of the main difficult tasks for me was to say, Because in big companies, you have a very strict flow, how you have to do things with budgeting, specs, and so on and so on. If I go to PHP.net and I say, oh, we need to have a decision, when will be the PHP 5.4, 5, now it's better. It was one of the reasons why we created the release process IFC, to standardize how much release we do, how we do it, and when. But for everything else, it was kind of a poker game. So, and it's still, like last example, my team lost 6 months of work because another big contributor just rewrote everything in the engine without telling anyone. So we just lost 6 months, and yet you have to explain to your management, hey guys, the last 6 months, nuts. So that's the kind of things it's very hard to work with, but you have to. And I think it's the best way when a company, small or big, have to contribute, have to work with an open source project, you have to work the way they do. You cannot simply go there with your big feet and say, hey guys, I'm the multi-billions company and I want that. You will just get kicked out. So what we do, most of the people working on PHP, for example, do not even know that the guys making this commit works for Microsoft, because we don't talk about that. We just do it. We do for Linux, we do for Symfony, we do a lot of QA, like we test every commit with 100 of your application. Doing the if you go on qaphp.net, you have all the reports we generated for every commit, every release, performance, regression, and so on. So the key points was how to adapt a very strict flow with somehow chaotic or very strict too for Apache, but chaotic for PHP, and how to make them work together. So this is what kind of a mess. And it's getting easier now because, like for Docker, you have many, many new, very good open source projects backed by companies. So it's easier now to get things done. I don't know if it's better, but at least it's easier. Yeah, there was always some people saying, oh, we don't want companies inside open source and so on, but this is business as usual. And the processes, as I said, it are the internal processes and the communities, and you have to make match them. I don't know what the most difficult is. For me, it was painful for both. So even if I was working since a couple of decades with open source, trying to match them on both sides, I was like, I don't remember the name, if you have a hammer and you have to slam a piece of metal, and I was in the middle. So I was like, okay guys, can we get an agreement here? No, okay. And if you target, open source is about public. So you do something for the public, you do something for the end user, for education, university, and so on. What does it mean? Does it mean that you have to do private discussions? Is it good, for example, to have private discussion about open source projects? Even about discussing an ID? Let's say you have a new idea about Docker. Will you first discuss this idea internally in the company in a small committee, and when you are almost done, post something on the mailing list?
Not necessarily inside the company, but...
Well, a small group of people anyway, chatting.
I do know the people who are most likely to be interested.
Yeah. A bit, yeah.
So that we don't say something or implement something that's completely useless.
Yeah. Exactly. So that means get in touch with the guys. One of my favorite open source project is called Cairo. Who knows Cairo? Okay, it's one of the backend for X. Oh, it's not X anymore, but it's used by Mozilla. Or it was used by Firefox. It's a vector graphic libraries. 3 minutes? Okay. So, and the basic ideas for them is, you have an ID, post it. We discuss it. Because the last thing we want is that you waste your time for a patch we won't accept. So just discuss the idea from the very, 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 very beginning. Except you sit down at a beer, what do you think about that? Okay. But once you see the idea may be useful, post it. Some projects are not used to that, but they will be. Because that's the only way. Because you don't know what the other guys are working on. You don't know what they think about. Some people never go to conferences and so on and so on. So just do it and keep things open. That's the only way to work. And this is the hard part I have now, still now, even internally at Microsoft or with customers contributing to project. I say, always try to tell them, guys, we stop this meeting now, we make a summary, and we send it to the list. And then we see the reaction and we continue. That's what we did, for example, for the 6 months patch, it was for the 64-bit support. We did that from the very first beginning. We have a prototype, posted it on the list. And we posted updates every week. And 6 months later, the other company just posted like millions of lines change without telling anyone. And that's exactly the opposite. And this the best example to see how you can waste other people's time. And then things get worse, then the people get angry, and you have more politics, and you do everything you want but code, which is not exactly what I like to do. I mean, the politics part, the code, yes. Yes?
I'm sorry to interrupt, but I am going to let you know that you're out of
time. I'm out of time now?
Yes.
Oh. So, discuss openly, and I'm done. Ah. Thank you very much. I hope it was not too, I mean, you know all that, I think.
If you're around, you can ask questions in the break.
I always to catch up on you because you are late. I always have to go to shop.